welcome back to Jubilee Kids for another fun week. I hope you've been keeping well. So, we are back to spot the difference this week. So have a good look around me, see what's there, and see what might change at some point during this video. We are going to go straight over to our Feature the Leader section, and today we have the wonderful Guru who's coming to talk to us.
Morning, Jubilee. Good night. I miss you guys so much. I just wanted to check in with you guys and see how you're doing during this lockdown. What I absolutely love is waking up in the morning and waking up to a nice, clean, crisp sky with the sun just peeking through, and reading a book or just saying a gratitude of prayer. I am currently outside and I just want to show you the beautiful sky. Now, look at the beautiful view right now, the sounds of nature, and I just sit here for about 5 to 10 minutes and just give a quick prayer of gratitude, of thanks God for waking me up this morning, and just thanking Him for all the opportunities and the blessings that He has for me. So I just wanted to encourage you guys not to give up, hang in there, keep having fun, and just to be grateful. I love you guys so much and I miss you and I can't wait to see you guys again.
Thanks so much for that, Gugu. What a fantastic reminder of the importance of looking up and being grateful for the way that God blesses us each day. Now here's a picture of Anna Harvey, who was worshipping to our Jubilee Kids music last week. Thanks so much for sending that in. Now you might have noticed that there's a couple of big words next to me on the wall. And these words say, the Psalms. Wonder if you can say that. The Psalms. This is a funny word because it starts with a big P, but you can't hear it. It sounds like it starts with the S. Now the Psalms are some books in the Bible. Now, you might want to pause your video now and go and find a Bible. It needs to be one that has the Psalms in it. So maybe ask your mums and dads if they could help you find a grown-up Bible and bring it with you. Okay, off you go. Okay, great. Have you got your Bible? This is my very special Bible here. Now, I want to challenge you to try and find the Psalms in the Bible. Now, an easy way to do that is look, this very thick book, and open it about halfway like that, can you see? And then you'll probably be in a book that's called Isaiah, and then you're going to go back a little bit, back a little bit, back a little bit, until you can see a word on the top of the page that says Psalms. There we go. Now the Psalms were songs written by a man in the Bible who's very famous. His name was David, and he wrote these songs to God. Some of them are sad, some of them are happy, but they all teach us some really important things about our God. And we're going to be hearing about them over the next 4 weeks. Here's one more challenge for you while you've got your Bible open. Can you see how many Psalms there are in total? Have a quick look and shout the number out at the screen. I'm going to have a look too. Did you find out? How many did you say? 10? No, more than 10. 20, more than 20. That's right, 150 Psalms in the Bible. That's a lot of songs, isn't there? We're not going to be looking at all of them. We're going to be looking at a couple each week to help you learn more about the importance of this book. So we asked you this week to send us in a video or a message telling us what your favourite psalm is. And we had two of those. The first is from Ross, Caleb and Anna Harvey, who sent us in a little video of Psalm 19, and the second is of Mia being the Good Shepherd from Psalm 23. So have a look at these now.
Right, guys, what psalm do we love? We love Psalm 19, okay, and it's called "The Law of the Lord is Perfect." It says, "The heavens declare the glory of God, and the sky above proclaims His handiwork."
These are my sheep. I'm always giving the everything they need.
Now I'm going to hand over to Chloe for an introduction to our lesson.
Hi everyone, my name is Chloe and I help out in the Flame Room at the Ops Church.
I have two art investigators with me here today, Jesse and Phoebe. And we were in the garden looking at all of God's beautiful flowers and felt inspired to paint them. But first, we thought we might see how some well-known artists have captured their beauty. So pay close attention to what we found now, everyone.
We found Rachel Roysch, who painted every tiny detail that she saw.
We found Vincent van Gogh, who explored all the different shades of just one colour, especially enjoying the yellow sunflower.
We found Vladimir Cherchikov, who liked painting the bright and vibrant colours.
We found Edouard Manet, who loved to capture the freshness of the soft flowers and how the light played in the water.
Now I wonder if you can match these four works to their artists, having seen a little of their styles. Pause the video here and give it a try. Did you look carefully? Could you figure it out? Could you look at the works of the artist's hands and know who painted them? Today's Bible lesson is a song about the works of God's hands and how we can know it is His work. When we see the work of God's hands, we really know we need to praise Him, which leads us to our memory verse with Joy, Manuel, and Decker.
Hi guys, my name is Joy and this is
Becca.
And this is?
Manuel.
We want to welcome you to this new series, Memory Verse this month. And the memory verse is from the book of Psalms.
Chapter 19.
Verse 1. And it says?
The heavens show the glory of God.
And the skies
announce what His hands have made. Book of Psalms.
Chapter 19.
Verse 1. And it says?
The heavens show the glory of God.
Guys.
Announce what His hands have made.
Thank you so much, Joy, Manuel and Becca and Chloe, for those parts of the lesson. That was so much fun. I'm going to hand you over to Jason now, who's going to do the story with us.
Hey Jubilee kids, wow, isn't that amazing? The heavens do tell of the glory of God. Today we're going to have some fun. It's going to be a really interactive lesson. So what I want you to go and do is quickly grab a pen and a paper. Why don't you go do that now? Great. Now that you're ready, I want you to listen to these beautiful Bible verses with me from Psalm 19 and watch this cool stop motion. You ready? Let's go.
The heavens tell the glory of God, and the skies announce what His hands have made. Day after day they tell the story. Night after night they tell it again. They have no speech or words. They don't make any sound to be heard. But their message goes out through all the world. It goes everywhere on earth.
Wow! Aren't those amazing words? Wasn't that a beautiful animation? I wonder if you understand what those words were saying. Why don't you pause the video now and go and take a look outside. I want you to look up at the sky and then come back.
Great Jubilee kids. How would you describe the sky? What do you see in the sky? The sun? The moon? Clouds? Stars? Now think about the one who created the sky. What do you think about him? How big do you think he must be? How clever do you think he must be?
Okay, now it's your turn to put some drawing to these words. Have you got your pen and paper ready? Right. You can draw anything. There are no rules. So why don't you listen up?
The sky was made at the Lord's command. By the breath from His mouth, He made all the stars. He gathered the water in the sea into a heap. He made the great ocean stay in its place. All the earth should worship the Lord. The whole world should fear him. He spoke, and it happened. He commanded, and it appeared. I wonder what you have drawn. This is what my kids drew when I read this psalm to them. But what these verses from the Bible have told us about, and what my kids' drawings have shown, is the work of God's hands, our glorious Creator.
You see, even if people choose to ignore the truth about God, anyone anywhere in the world can look around them and know about him by his wonderful creation. When we see that God is the great and mighty Creator, we should be like creation and sing his praise. So why don't you guys join me in worshiping God together now?
Hi everyone, so we've just heard about our amazing Creator God, and now we're going to praise him with a song that you all know very well. So why don't you get up and come and do some actions with me? Here we go.
Our God is a great big God.
Thank you so much for your wonderful creation and what it teaches us about you. I pray for everyone watching today that this week they might see beauty around them and just be amazed by who you are and how you bless us each day. Amen. Wow, what a wonderful lesson it's been, full of so many images, drawings, paintings, and photographs that all show us God's amazing creation. Now, we're really excited to see your pictures that you've hopefully started drawing. Maybe you can finish those off and send them in to us. And I also have another challenge for you. Why don't you take a photograph? Ask your mums and dads if you can borrow a camera or a phone When you're out and about, look for things that are beautiful and take a photograph of them. And as you do, thank God for his creation and then send us in the photograph, because we want to make a beautiful montage of your pictures and your photographs. Okay, have a great week, everyone. Bye.
Your righteousness is like the mighty